What's up, guys? This is part two of the Subaru Impreza rear disc brake conversion video. It took me a while to get back to y'all on it. I promised y'all I was going to take you with me. I'm probably not going to record the right side. It's the same thing as doing the left side. It's just the opposite side. But I'm probably going to do some footage of this car after I get it going. Every year about this time my allergies get messed up, and this year is no exception. You hear me sniffing. Probably gonna get a sinus infection. I always try to dose up on Benadryl, but it don't always work. Suspension arm right here. Alright. Got it. Get this nut. Get it on here. Got an air hammer with a chisel on it. I'm gonna go around here and knock this back plate off. One. Oh yeah, it's turning. Nothing wrong with that. All right. All the hold. All right, guys, I had to get my wife to help me because I got to put this strut up in here while somebody puts a nut on it.
And this thing?
Yep.
Okay. Do it on the side. I'm starting them off.
Okay, start them all. It's fine.
Hold on,
I'm
trying to get them on there.
I'm back out here. I'm having an allergy attack today. I can't really breathe. Having a rough time. I have a rough time with them allergies sometimes. It is what it is. I need to get this wheel speed sensor harness back up through the floorboard. I need to get this parking brake cable hooked back up. All right, it's looking like I'm gonna need a flashlight. See the hole it goes in. Feed that wheel speed sensor harness up through that hole. Got the car sitting on blocks of wood. But if you look right here, there's a bracket. But this one goes there too. Both of them do. So I think this one goes first like that. And this one goes. So what I like to do is, I'll take my bolt, go through both of them like this, and set it up there. ratchet wrenches with me, so just take my time and run this in. I just took my time. I still messed my finger up. It is what it is. But you want to always make sure that you put everything back the way it goes, because there's a reason why they got all these brackets that hold these cables down. Sorry if I'm breathing really hard, y'all. My nose is stopped up. But yeah, it's taking my time and just putting this all back like it's supposed to be. I gotta run this around here. Let's see. Like so. It goes up through the floor pan. But I gotta put this jack back up under here and get a jack stand so it's safe before I crawl up under there. Probably put the tire back on it too so it can't fall. Brake on here. The only thing I need to do before I put this back on is I need to bleed this caliper a little bit. If I can get this to come loose. Doing a brake bleed by myself, just pumping it and opening it, pumping it, opening it without having anybody push. If it's got air in it later, I can bleed it some more. It's no big deal. But I don't have any help right now, so just gotta do what I can by myself. Just grommet back in this floor pan. Like so. Alright, this is exactly why I cut this right here off. Because if you look, this came out of a 98 Forester, and this is a 2002. Okay, they're the same, but if you look, I need to take this and hook it into here, solder and heat shrink it in, because if not, it's not going to plug in. So that's why I cut that off the other car. That's why I told you on the last video that you needed to get the connector just in case, because sometimes they change it from year to year on your sensor. But I should be able to solder and heat shrink these back together, black to black, white to white, and it shouldn't be any problem. Let's see. So I'm using my phone actually right now, recording and looking at it and using it for a mirror. Kind of, so I'm not up under the car. I'm kind of back a little bit, and I can see my screen on my phone, and that's how I'm doing this. I'm gonna put that in right there, get it started a couple threads. All right, started. Now I'm gonna spin this around here. There should be a hole in the floor pan, and there it is. Close to the end of where that cable's at. It don't go very far. You gotta get your cable started through your hole in your floor pan. See it right there? Yeah, get your cable started in there. Now you're gonna pull that all the way through the floor pan when you get up to the top and make that grommet fit back in there. Make sure it's not rubbing your drive shaft. And then you gotta come in here with an extension and a 12. Tighten that up. I'm gonna do that now. I got my 3/8 impact extension in my 12. See if I can get up in here. Cable's running around, it's going to go in that hole where the grommet's at. The other cable on the other side, you can see, goes in right beside it. Let's take it out to do the other side here in a minute. Appreciate y'all watching my rear disc brake conversion video. If you liked it, hit that subscribe button. Talk to y'all next time.